All right, this is Scott here with FanPage Engine, and we are on step three on our deals app. And this is basically just the publish step. So what happens here, once you go over to step three, you're gonna see a preview of what the deal looks like to fans when they come to the page. This is what they would see. It just kind of gives you a quick little preview of what it looks like here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna click save and update. And then this is gonna take me over to the deal. And so what you'll see here is you'll see a couple things. Because you're an admin, you're seeing the edit this deal button. Your users are not gonna see that, your fans are not gonna see that. What they're gonna see is basically from here down. They're gonna see the image that I loaded, which this showed the special that we had for the deal package for a while. It shows them that there are 10 deals remaining based on whatever you're talking about up here. And then we got a cool little counter here that shows when the deal is gonna end, and it shows exactly when it is gonna end, how the days, the hours, minutes, and seconds. And then, you know, it has the button that I pushed. I put yes, I want in. They would push that here. And there's also the share button here and the terms of services over here. All those things are exactly what we showed in the other steps. And so that is step three of getting your deal published. So it's completely ready to go from there. There's nothing else that you need to do except for if you want to go back in and edit it. At any point, you can just click on edit and go back in, and then you can edit the deal and change it however you want. You know, if you want to make a change on it, you want to change out, let's say I want this to go to, I meant to say 100, not, you know, 10. So I would go down, I'm going to click the next step here at the bottom. And then I'll go back, oops, I scrolled. Go back up. So I'm just going to go back to, I'm going to go to step three. I'm going to click save and update. Well, you can see there here, because I've saved this and updated it, the deal is on now, and I can right here and from the app itself, I can choose to turn the deal off or on, and it would show differently, and I'll show you what it looks like here in a second. But I click save and update. Now look, there's 100 deals remaining because I've gone in and changed that. Now if I want to turn the deal off, I just go back into it, go to step three, and then I can immediately turn the deal off. And if I click save and update, when I go over to Facebook now, what's going to show is going to show the deal is coming soon. So it shows there's nothing there. So when users come to it, they're not seeing anything at all. So that's how you can easily turn it off right from inside the app. And if I'm going to go back and turn it back on, just click on that, hit save and update. And then now the deal will be back on. And I also wanted to show you inside your back office here, the deals app, you'll see here this Hubsy Squad deal demo. That's the one that I just made. You can see that now it's changed to active status because I've activated it. If I want to pause it, I just click pause. And watch, when I go back over to this app after everything's updated, if I click refresh, the page will now show that this app is now coming soon, is basically what it'll end up showing once Facebook decides to load here. There, see, now it shows the deal is coming soon. So I can pause it from inside Facebook if I want to, or I can do it from inside my back office. Now keep in mind, if you're running these for a client through your agency plan, you can go in and you can suspend this app from inside here, and now the app will be completely turned off. The admins of the pages will not be able to go in and do anything. It'll all be completely shut off from inside this back office. And so you can control it. If you're an agency member, you can go in and click suspended. Now, if I go over to this app and click refresh, we'll wait for it to load again. And you see there, this deal is suspended. So users will see that and admins see that as well. So there's nowhere for me to admin now. So I do not have access to this deal anymore unless I have access to the back office. So that I can go back and make it active again. Once I know it's loaded, which looks like it is now, if I go back and hit refresh, then now the deal will show up and show it's active and give me the option to go in and edit it the whole nine yards. So as an agency member, you're able to do that. So you're able to control whether it's off or on the page. So if you have a client that maybe was paying you per month to run it and now they're not, you can just turn it off or they don't have access to it anymore. So that is step three and a little bit more of the deals app. Hopefully you found this useful.